Hey folks, time for a little update on this DR1 that I fixed up a while back. It is about a week since I left town and turned it off. Now I left the door open with some tape. The tape is there just so it won't drift all the way open and be out here in the walk path. I did that because I didn't want moisture to stay trapped inside it. So again, it's been off and unplugged, so I'm going to plug it in and give it some time for the heater to work before I start it. And the machine is off other than the heater, which is always active. So you can see the off in there. So I'm going to give it, I don't know, about 4 hours, I would say. You can see right now it's about 9 a.m. So probably after lunch I'll start it up and we'll see how it sounds and how long it takes it to start cooling. And I might as well take this time to kind of give a pre-intro to another project that's upcoming. Y'all may recognize these parts that are on this cart as all the working parts of a Frigidaire 30s model, you know, belt drive Frigidaire, like a W series. So this belongs to another enthusiast who sent me all the parts, and I'm going to try to make all this work again. It's going to be challenging though because I won't have a real cabinet to test it in. I haven't yet figured out exactly how I'm going to rig up a test, but I'm going to have to, you know, run it, and all the parts have to work together. So I'll have to find some way to mount the evaporator in the right position in some sort of a cabinet, and be able to run the unit. So that's upcoming. Now it probably won't be extremely soon, but it's going to be upcoming. All right. Well, time got away. It's a little bit later than I thought, but going to go ahead and start this thing up. The heater's been active all morning, probably from 9 till afternoon, 2 o'clock. 6 hours, I guess, 5 or 6 hours. So let's start it up here. I hear boiling. All right, so I'm going to let her run and check back in 15-20 minutes and see how the cooling is going. All right, it's been a few minutes. It's gotten slightly louder, nothing I would call alarming. Just a little bit of heat in the coils, a little tiny bit in the dome. If we look in here, we're already down to about 5 degrees, or maybe 10. So, looks like everything's going well at this point. I'll check back again if it gets louder or quieter, or if it finally cuts off. Well, still running, and it quieted back down to the way it sounded last time I had it going. There's the time. And we're right at zero, or a little below. Got a nice frost buildup in there. So now all the coils are warm, bottom one's maybe not quite as warm, but there, it's definitely warm all the way down. And the float's definitely warmer than the top. It's cool in here. It's about 60 degrees in the room. Actually, there's a thermometer right there. So it's nothing's hot, but there's definitely a difference in that and that. So yeah, looks like this one is working fine after being laid up for a week and started back up. I wasn't like really worried about it, but you never know after all the concerns that we've had about these with the R152A, you know, you just never know. So it's experimental. So far, so good. Well, it's finally cycled off. I wasn't paying attention, so it could have been off for a while. It's been off a while. It's up back up to about 5 or 10 degrees. All right, that's a good sign.